And what are some good examples of accessible products?
So one example I like to share are Google Docs and Drive. I feel like they've come a long way over the past year and a half.
Yeah, and what sorts of things do you feel like they've done really, really well?
Well, as you can see here on the Google Docs app, there's a lot of good things that they have considered. One is good contrast between the text and the background colors. They support large fonts really well, so that when you do enlarge the fonts on here, that essential items or elements aren't getting cut off. Mm-hmm. You're able to zoom in where you need to, and they also have really good screen reader support. And screen readers are really interesting assistive technologies to design for. There's a lot to consider because they not only read the content, like the words that are on the screen, but they also read and announce the different elements that are on the screen, such as buttons and links and menus. And some of the aspects of a good experience with the screen reader and things you need to take into consideration are one, ensuring that the way the user kind of goes through the page and the screen, that the elements are in a logical order, so mm-hmm. it kind of goes left to right, top down, if that's how the elements are laid out on the screen. But another key thing that is really important is what we call the labels, or how things are labeled on the screen. So again, getting back to this, the notion that the buttons and links and elements like that are read to the user, you want to ensure that those have clear and concise labels, and they're very contextual. Mm-hmm. So I think a good example here is, let's say you have a screen that has, let's say, emails or search results on there, and you have pagination controls, like a next and previous button below. Instead of having the screen reader just read out next or previous, having a bit more context, like next 50 emails or next 50 results, is really, really beneficial and a very small change from the designer's point of view.
Right. I mean, I could imagine like maybe seeing a buy button, but it's like, well, buy what?
You know? One thing that's really important to understand is the way screen readers work. They go through the page very linearly. Mm-hmm. And so by the time they traverse through the site and reach the buttons that are usually at the bottom of the page, they might have lost some context of where they were.
Yeah. So how can I work with a screen reader? Like, where would I go to use that or use it with a product?
The great thing about screen readers, especially on mobile, is that they're already built in. So if you have an Android or Apple phone, you can easily go to the settings, and within there are accessibility settings, and you can turn on TalkBack for Android, and on Apple, it's VoiceOver. Mm. And what I tell everybody is turn that on and try to use your phone for a day and get that experience doing your daily tasks, but only using a screen reader. And the key there is to not look at your screen. So closing your eyes or dimming your screen for a day and just see if you can achieve your everyday tasks.
Wow. That sounds pretty tough. What sort of other concerns are there for maybe mobile accessibility?
I think one of the unique things about mobile is it's a touch screen. So one key thing to keep in mind are the touch target sizes and ensuring that they're large enough. And this isn't just for people with disabilities. We all have different shaped hands and levels of dexterity. And so considering that, and that ensuring that you don't need a small pen tip to actually focus in on a button or something like that is extremely important and valuable.
And what other considerations are there for accessibility?
Well, there's definitely a lot more, but I think one other important one that we touched on a little bit before is color contrast. And I think it's a good one to focus on because you can focus on it early, just in the design and mock stage, and it's an easy thing to consider. And so there is a specific color contrast ratio that you need to meet in order to achieve these standards. The great thing about this is there's a ton of online color contrast checkers that you can simply plug in your hex codes of your text color and your background color and see if you meet these standards. So it's really easy, and again, just something you can take care of and think about really early on in the design process.
Yeah.